The Finnish phone maker you know and love is gone, and in its place the new 535 is the first Lumia to bear Microsoft's name. But is that all that's changed? The first thing you'll probably notice is that the Microsoft brand is everywhere. It's even part of the boot up animation. Then you'll notice how big this thing is. The 535 is a variable phablet by comparison to its predecessors. That said, it doesn't feel all that chunky, with an impressive waistline that's just 8.8mm thick, and a relatively low weight for a phone of this size at 146 grams. The body itself also boasts some nice rounding along the sides, tactile hardware controls, and only the smallest of camera bumps. The removable polycarbonate backplate features a high gloss finish, and as per the 2014 Lumia family, is offered up in an array of punchy colours too. Pick up most Lumias and you'll likely be treated to a pretty enjoyable display experience. The majority offer up great blacks, good viewing angles, strong overall brightness, and even the added bonus of glance view in some cases. The belt tightening rules that the Lumia 535 adheres to means that it doesn't quite measure up to its comrades in this regard. Its 5-inch screen is fairly bright, but more aggressive viewing angles suffer heavily from distortion. Colours aren't as punchy as its siblings, and the QHD resolution at such a large size is detrimental to picture quality. Not to mention, it can be downright unresponsive at times. The Windows Phone 8.1 experience hasn't changed much with the 535, but that's okay. There are a ton of Lumia branded apps out the box, Mix Radio for free music streaming, and Microsoft's Bing Suite for info on news, health, sport, and more. It may not be the most innovative Lumia, but it does all the basics well. The 535 is also a dual SIM handset, unusual in the UK market, and as such receives two sets of phone and messaging apps, as well as tools to control either SIM independently from the settings menu. When you weigh up the user experience performance balance offered by the Lumia 535, it's kind of surprising that this is the device Microsoft decided to finally stamp its mark upon. The pairing of 1GB of RAM and a 1.2GHz quad-core Snapdragon 200 brain gives you smoother operability when swiping between the start screen and apps menu, but beyond this, performance appears to take a hit, with long load times for apps and actions. One notable advantage of being a big phone is that you get a big battery, and although there's a modest sounding 1950 mAh cell, we managed a snip under a day and a half between charges. As this is a budget offering, connectivity is limited to 3G data, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and GPS, but 4G and NFC are sadly absent. The 535 makes up for these omissions with its robust storage capabilities, however, boasting 128GB microSD support and 15GB of cloud storage, useful as there's only 8GB built in. The Lumia Selfie app is one of a number of photography-focused applications that the 535 totes from the off, and as such, it can pull the same trick as the selfie-centered Lumia 735 by making an average mugshot significantly prettier with a bit of post-processing wizardry. Hardware-wise, the front-facing 5-megapixel snapper is decent enough for things you typically rely on a front facer for, and the rear camera, which promises the same 5-megapixel sensor size, is also surprisingly clear. On the phone's display, shots may look a little bit naff, but on larger, sharper screens, there's actually a surprising amount of clarity. That doesn't detract from the fairly flat-looking snaps overall. Sub-HD resolution video recording and terrible low-light performance that's noisier than Spinal Tap turned up to 11. As ever with Lumia devices, the one saving grace is the Lumia camera app, giving you impressively high levels of manual control over everything from ISO and focus to white balance and shutter speed. As we mentioned earlier, the Lumia 535 is an interesting choice for Microsoft to place its mark on. The Lumia 930 or the next flagship in the pipeline would have made more sense, but siding with the affordable pushes a different message to consumers. If you want a taste of the Lumia brand, we wouldn't dissuade you from the 535 entirely, but it might pay to look further back into 2014 and grab the Lumia 635, or grab a more competent budget offering like Huawei's Ascend Wi-Fi 50, which boasts better hardware and 4G for a similar price. If you want to know more about the Lumia 535, head to recombu.com/mobile. Thanks for watching. Performance, power, you love it, I love it, everyone wants it, and the 930 has it. This has a quad-core processor, and that makes it a veritable